Hey Cloud Gurus, I'm Gwen and welcome to Linux This Month. Today we'll be discussing some of the things that have happened this past month in the world of Linux. We'll start off with some CentOS news. Linux kernel 5.10 is finally out. LibreOffice 7.1 is now in public beta. Xfce 4.16 has been released, and we'll also share with you some of our 2021 Linux predictions. If you don't want to miss out on more Linux news, make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. On December 8th, 2020, Chris Wright, the Red Hat CTO, and Rich Bowen, the CentOS project community manager, announced that moving forward, there will be no CentOS Linux and only CentOS Stream. Also, CentOS 8 support will end this year, 2021, and CentOS 7 support is set to end in 2024. Stream was originally announced in September 2019 and serves as a, quote, a rolling preview of what's next in real, unquote. CentOS, however, originally served as a rebuilt free version of real, so you can imagine that the community reaction is overwhelmingly negative. That includes the reaction of CentOS co-founder Greg Kurtzer, who has announced the launch of a new project, Rocky Linux. Cloud Linux has also announced a CentOS clone named Lennox. Whether Rocky Linux and Lennox turn into what CentOS used to be is yet to be determined, but we all know when there's a strong community, possibilities are endless. Linux 5.10 is both the latest mainline kernel update and the latest long-term support release. It's set to be maintained until 2026. The update includes a bunch of features and changes, both big and small, including performance improvements to BTRFS operations. ext4 gets a major write performance boost, hardware monitoring for AMD Zen 3 processors, and support for Nintendo Switch Joy-Cons and Pro Controllers. After 6 months of development, the Document Foundation has announced that LibreOffice 7.1 Office Suite is now available for public beta testing, with the final release expected in early February 2021. This new version brings a ton of improvements and a few new features, including a new outline, folding mode, and new table formulas for Writer. Calc is getting better spell checking performance, better searching in autofilter, a new feature called Additions Dialog. Draw will now let you add visible signatures to existing PDF files. Impress will allow you to change animations for multiple objects at the same time. And Math now offers full support for HTML colors. These are just some of the changes to make LibreOffice more stable and reliable. The Xfce 4.16 desktop environment has been officially released. This new stable version makes a number of visual changes, usability enhancements, and bug fixes, including an update to its icons and overall visual identity. Numerous improvements to the X11 Windows Manager, a new plugin for the Xfce 4 panel to serve as both the status notifier and the system tray items, support for fractional scaling, file manager improvements, fixes across the desktop, and a number of other changes. With this being the first episode of 2021, it only makes sense that we take a look into the future and predict what surprises Linux may have for us.
Hey there, fellow Cloud and Linux geeks. It's Ross again, and I'm so glad 2020 is gone. But with a new year upon us, I've consulted the Oracle, and I don't mean the one that does databases. And here's what they told me will be some of those great things that will happen to us this year. First, I think this is the year that Microsoft's chokehold on the end-user computing world starts to slip even more, with the recent acquisition of Red Hat by IBM and the Intel HPE Clear Linux or Clear OS project's momentum gains. A lot of the same functionality that was previously restricted to Windows is increasingly available via Linux and through the cloud. The cost and security of deployment are huge issues, and the inherent security advantages, ability to customize every aspect of, and the new and innovative pricing models will cause savvy IS and IT managers to turn increasingly towards Linux for large client deployments, data center uses, and even providing Windows user and application endpoints via the cloud. Second, Microsoft will not take this laying down, and so we'll see Azure Sphere gaining more functionality, attracting more vendors to make their products compatible, and even Azure Sphere Guardian devices that can be the interface between previously unconnected devices already in place and the Azure Security Services. Here comes Skynet. The Internet of Things will take off even more rapidly, not with silly things like internet-connected toasters and Apache-enabled refrigerators, but with managed, monitored, patched, updated, and secured real-world devices, all without having to replace those before their end of life. And third, the world of Linux distributions won't slow down any. With Linux Mint continuing its massive popularity, Ubuntu attempting a resurgence that may not happen, and Arch Linux users continuing to aggressively mention their distribution of choice without being asked. Fedora will continue on in its current role, OpenSUSE will slowly gain market share as more folks are looking for alternatives to the Red Hat behemoth that's being slowly absorbed into IBM land, and us all bidding a tearful farewell to the awesomeness that used to be CentOS. Moment of silence. Well, that's it for me this time. Keep your systems up and your downtime down, and we'll see you next month.
Hey, Cloud Gurus, it's Mike, and I hope that so far your year is shaping up to be a great one. With this being the first episode of this year, it's time to look into the crystal ball and make some Linux and open source predictions for 2021. Now, first, I think this will be the year of ARM. With Apple leading the way and porting over to ARM, we'll see some real development horsepower applied to the platform. And even though it's a very closed ecosystem, I think there'll be some ripple effect and you will see more ARM-based influence this year in the broader community. I mean, Ubuntu's last release had a version for Raspberry Pi, right? Second, I think you're gonna see a new distro picking up major speed and adoption this year. I think that Rocky Linux is gonna be the new hotness. This is due to changes in the CentOS project and the end of life of regular CentOS and a new stream that replaces it. Rocky is a fork that aims to take the place of CentOS for stable enterprise-grade server workloads, so keep an eye on this one. Third, I think this might be the year that Linux gaming really takes off. With all the new code base heading to ARM led by Apple, I think there's gonna be a drift away from DirectX, and we'll see Vulkan really up its game. The folks at Steam are making huge strides in getting major titles up on Linux, and I think this year there'll be some deals made and that Linux on the desktop will get some major love. That's it for my predictions. If you think I'm crazy, let me know in the comments. Also, let me know what you think will be the big stories in Linux and open source this year. Anyway, till next time.
Alrighty, if you liked the show, be sure to give this episode a big thumbs up. Any questions, make sure to leave it in the comments. May your source remain open and your code compile. See you in the next episode. Subscribe to stay up to date and keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus.